Today I'm showing you PitchLoop89 in Ableton Live 11. PitchLoop89 is a device with two pitch shifting delays. It allows you to create all kinds of jittery glitch effects and delayed shimmers. In this video, we will 1. Take a look at some presets and 2. Learn how the device works to create your own presets. I also made a preset myself. You can download it for free by going to the first link in the description. My name is Matt Flank. Let's get started. I made a little project to show you some of the presets. Let's take a listen. So now that you know what kind of effects PitchLoop89 can produce, I'll show you how to use the device yourself. After watching this part of the video, you'll be able to create your own effects. Firstly, there is the global bandwidth and the mode, which allows for signal-informed crossfades. I won't go in detail about this, but there is a link in the description to the website of PitchLoop89 in case you want to know more about it. Position and display. The plugin can be divided horizontally to separate the two pitch shifting units. You can use the left and right pitch shifting units independently, or link them together by selecting the V. The first knob I want to show you is the position. You can see this as the delay time. This value is also displayed on the screen. You can also modulate the position by turning on the LFO, choosing the wave, and setting the rate and depth. However, when hold is enabled, this acts as the starting position of the playback loop. The random knob will set a random starting position at the beginning of each new segment. A segment is, simply put, the length of a delay slice. Pitch shifting. Obviously, since PitchLoop89 is a pitch shifting device, we can change the pitch of the delays. We can do this manually or modulate it with the vibrato. Filter. Both pitch shifters have a low cut and a high cut filter. Pretty straightforward. Feedback. You can choose how each pitch shifter is sent to the output. L/R feeds each pitch shifter back to its own input. Sum combines both feedback signals and sends them back to both inputs. Cross routes the signal from the left channel to the input of the right one, and vice versa. Output. Each channel has its own gain control. You can adjust the stereo panning. And lastly, there is a dry-wet knob. And that is it for the basics of PitchLoop89. If you want to learn more detailed stuff about this plugin, you can go to the website which is linked in the description. On there, you can read more about the history of the plugin, what it is based on, and all technical information. But for now, thank you guys for watching. I hope to see you in the future. And if you want to see more videos by me, consider subscribing. I make videos about free plugins, making music, production tips and tricks, and more. Thank you so much for watching. My name is Matt Flank. Peace out.